Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding All's Not Well in the Army, written by Happimon Jacob. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science optional students. Now in order to understand this editorial, we need to understand two things. First of all, we need to understand the importance of career policy. And secondly, we need to understand the issues about personal management in army. And in this we need to discuss and understand two things: the recommendations of Ajay Vikram Singh committee. And then we need to also understand the command and exit model suggested by Ajay Vikram Singh. First of all, let us understand career policy. Now, what is meant by career policy? Career policy is a policy in any organization which takes into consideration how the motivation and the morale of an organization needs to be maintained, which takes into consideration the needs of an employee, and accordingly the training programs are designed, accordingly promotions of an employee is done, accordingly transfer of an employee is done. So career policy is a very important policy of an organization. Now if the career policy will be doing injustice to the employees, in that case the employees will not feel motivated. Employees will not be able to give their best to an organization. Employees will leave an organization. Employees will feel disenchanted from the functioning of an organization. So it is important to constitute and implement an effective career policy, personal career policy. If the personal career policy will not be implemented, it will cause loss in terms of productivity and efficiency of an organization. Now, why am I discussing this career policy? Now, this is important because in this editorial, Happimon Jacob has highlighted the issue of supersession. What is meant by supersession? Supersession means when you tend to promote the juniors to a higher position, ignoring the seniors. When you ignore the principle of seniority at the higher level and tend to promote the juniors, that is known as principle of supersession. Now this principle of supersession should not be used in an organization which don't perform functions that are of innovative nature. Now when it comes to army, army has to perform a job of valor and sacrifice. Army has to perform a job which is more or less repetitive nature. Army has to perform a job which involves keeping the personals motivated, which involves keeping the personals imbibed with the spirit to sacrifice them for the nation. So this is what is required in an institution like that of army. So rarely you tend to do experiments, such experiments which are done in the organizations and the institutions which involves lot of scope in terms of innovating things. Army mein aapko bahut zyada innovate karne ka kuch zarurat nahi rehta hai. Army mein aapko sacrifice karna hai, army mein aapko valor show karna hai, army mein aapko apni strength show karni hai. And this army, it is based on a very important foundation. And this foundation is the foundation of command and control. This foundation is the foundation of discipline. So because of these things, discipline, command and control, the focus is always given on seniority whenever the chances of promotion are considered. You rarely resort to this merit aspect. Merit aspect is more about the organizations and the institutions which involve a lot of innovation. But this is something that is not required in army. So the supersession that has been recently resorted in case of Mr. Binney, he has been promoted as the general of the Indian Army by ignoring the two seniors. So in this case, basically, this is kind of an aberration in career personnel policy. Now, secondly, we need to understand the internal personnel aspects of army. Now, when it comes to the internal personnel aspects of army is not only constitutive of one aspect of personnel. In army, you have multiple, you have different type of personnel working. You have artillery, you have infantry, then you also have a mechanized division in army, and you have multiple other divisions. But when it comes to holding of the top most position in army, the personnel working under mechanized branches, in the engineering branches, in the council branches, they are generally ignored. More premium is placed on the personnel working in the artillery and working in the infantry. Sirf inke upar focus kiya jata hai jo artillery aur infantry mein work karte hain. And because artillery aur infantry walon ke upar zyada focus rehta hai jo baki ke employees hain, baki ke army personnel hain, they feel demotivated. And this is one reason why the army personnel, they have moved court in hundreds. So there are about thousands of cases pending about how the personnel aspect in the army is being managed. Now this is something that is not good for a country like India. Like we have neighbors which keep on instigating and which keep on impinging on our security. So in such a situation, we need kind of calm neighbor. We need to have a strong army. We need to strengthen and institute effective personnel management of army. Without effective personnel management of army, we will be demotivating army. So there is need to reduce politicization of army. And secondly, we need to democratize and infuse equality and equity among different types of personnel. Now, the current functioning of the promotion in army is based on Ajay Vikram Singh Committee's recommendation, and its recommendation has been the command and exit model. Now, what is this command and exit model? According to this command and exit model, anybody, any type of personnel whose number would be in higher proportion, they should be getting more chances to be elevated to the topmost position. Now, in case of Indian Army, you have infantry which is more in number. So basically, this is a kind of a biased model, command and exit model. This is based on pro rata basis. Now, what is pro rata basis? Kya hota hai? Jitni jiski zyada proportion hogi, usko utna hi zyada milega. So this actually caused the sense of dissatisfaction to set in the units that are holding mechanized functioning in army. So this is something that we really need to do away with. Now the question that can be asked in your mains exam, critically analyze what reforms should be introduced in the functioning of army setup. Critically analyze the personnel management of army, keeping in consideration how the supersession of Bini Rawat has taken over Lieutenant General Bakshi. So these two type of questions can be asked. And the third type, how the issue of religion should be kept apart in controlling the personnel in army. So this is another question that can be asked. So this was all for the day. You know, if you want to read more on this, visit brainyias.com. Now, you can also contact us on 845-940-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And in order to get the information of the classes, please visit brainyias.com. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice night.